Hi guys, hope everybody is doing really, really, really well. Everyone's living the dream. Everybody's on top of the moon. Right, today I've got some, I've had a big parcel come. I've opened it up because I'm not Jim. I don't make you all suffer. There you go. So you've seen it now, you can go. Right, so basically I've won two lots from Europe. I've just had it shipped across. Basically this big, massive 24 inch wrench, which I just love those. I can't help myself on those. I really need to go to Wrench Anonymous and stop buying wrenches. But anyway, let's not go into that for now. And then the second lot was these four lots. Now, I only bought it for one item. I wonder if you can guess which item it is the reason why I bid. If anyone got any ideas, let me know. But basically, it's this one. Now, I recently have purchased this Backhoe 41. But the handle has been, you know, badly fitted, like a refurb, and I paid a lot of money for this as well, and it's not really the best. Now this has got an original handle, I can't believe it, but the thing is, the blade on this one is really, really, really sharp, perfect, and this one, on the other hand, somebody's been hitting God knows what with that, and has chipped up all the blades, so it's like swings and roundabouts, but the handle is absolutely mint, new old stock, vintage handle. This has not been used at all, apart from someone hitting bloody metal or something. But this is a beautiful example of a Backhoe 41 from the 1920s, 30s. I mean, look at the end of that. I mean, absolutely sharp. So this is a stunning example. So when I saw, I already bought this one, and I saw this one, and I thought, do you know what? I'm pretty sure I can double stack them on the board. I'll go for it. So, yeah, this is a beauty. And I won this lot. I bid on this lot. And with it came these other three items, which are kind of interesting in their own right. I mean, especially these ones. These ones look really like blacksmith made. Like, that almost looks like it's part of a file. If you look at the handle, it looks like it's been beaten out of a file, doesn't it? I mean, these are really early blacksmith's made tongs, and I love the ends on them as well. Really, really, they've got something about them, these have. I mean, I didn't buy the lot and I wouldn't have bid on the lot, especially with the shipping for these, but they are really cool. I mean, I don't know what this step is here for, or maybe he's been hitting something with it, and that's what's I'm not sure. Kind of interesting though. So I wonder what you guys think of them. I think they're really, really funky looking. They've got a real look about them, they have. And then we've got a more ordinary set of tongs. These ones look like they could possibly be, manufactured rather than blacksmith made. In good condition, the actual tongs are in pretty sharp order. No issues there with that. But really, really cool. It's got a little nail puller on the end, and then this side. I think this has been forged. I think that's a seam. You can see the seam. Oh, hang on a minute. Here we go. It says made in Sweden. And if you can see that there. FABFSK something HI Fabska or something Sweden. Yeah, so these are manufactured Swedish pincers. And then to bring up the rear, we've got ourselves probably a 1960s or something Backhoe wrench. It's got the wider letter, which is kind of interesting, but it's got the thin design. It's probably from the 50s, this one, quite an early one. So, yeah, really, really nice. Little wrench. I'm sure that'll evaporust and clean up pretty, pretty nice. But this is the absolute star of the show for me. Absolute star. It's a stunner. I mean, it's just a shame about the blade, but the blade I can work with. The handle on the other hand, there's no way I could form that kind of handle, you know, with the dowels going through it. So that is an absolute stunner. Super happy with that. I mean, I'm not disappointed with that. I was very pleased when I got that. But there's a night and day between the handles on those, and there's no way I could make that handle that nice. Just no way. I can't do it. And then the last thing we bought, which was a separate lot, and I do love these items, is this humongous 24 inch. This is from like the 1920s, 30s. 24 inch, this needs a good old clean up. This will be a good old restoration. I've got a few of these to clean up, trust me. Backhoe, made in Sweden, number 24, nice look wrench. It's quite straight, You know, it's pretty straight, that film. Sometimes they've got some bend to them, and obviously they've got the thing. So that, and the jaws are actually pretty sharp as well on it. So this will actually be a good candidate for cleaning up. This is just rust. It's actually very, very good condition. It's just rust, this is. It's not got too many bangs, nicks or anything. So some really cool items there, if you don't agree. My favourite, obviously, is this Backo Axe, especially with that handle. It's stunning. I didn't realise the handle was so good because the picture was quite grainy. Hopefully you found this mildly interesting. Put in the description which item do you think the coolest. I don't blame anybody for going for this massive wrench. These pincers are super cool, and the axe. So I think there's three interesting items here, and then a couple of more generic ones. So put in the description how much you think I paid for the two lots. Don't forget, we've got postage on this and postage on this as well, so bear that in mind. And then obviously we've got four, so we've got five items in total. And put in the description which do you think's the coolest, or if you could have one. For me, it's a no-brainer. I'd go for the axe, the hatchet, or the crate tool, depending on what you call it. All right, hopefully you found this mildly interesting. Take care, have a great day, bye.